recycling my outfit from yesterday. I am recycling my hair from yesterday. Combed it out, resprayed it. I mean, are there any rules anymore? What day is it? I don't know. Nobody knows. I told Joel this summer with the kids I want to have minimal toys. There's just always so much laying around in the yard. But first things first, we want to get rid of any bikes that we don't need anymore. So this one, and then we need to decide if we're getting Cody a bike for his birthday or not. I don't think they need it. Like, I don't want to buy anything that we don't need. I know he really wants one, but his fits him just fine. And Lincoln's fits him just fine. They're both a little small, but
they can go on more seats.
Even if their bikes are just like a pinch small, like, I think we should just use what they've got. Olivia has my old bike. I don't think we should buy a new bike.
Just give Cody a birthday cake for his birthday. We're in quarantine. That's okay.
All right. We'll think about this. Okay.
This one's gotta go to the DI.
Yes, this one can go to the DI, which is a little sad, but so if we're doing that, then Lincoln's will go to the DI. We'll do that a different day. It's kind of sad to get rid of this guy, but we don't really use it as much. Lincoln. Oh my gosh. All right. Well, have fun.
We're gonna make a
sandball. A sandball? Awesome. That little scooter can go to the DI. I mean,
no, I want to keep that.
I think the kids use that.
I think they use that one.
Yeah, I think they use that. I mean, it's hammered. Oh. Keep the chairs. We just need to clean this thing out. Oh, this is so sad. That was Olivia's. And then it was Cody's, and then it was Boston's, and then it was yours, and we don't need it anymore.
It's been through, I can't believe it's made it this long.
Oh, so cute. Once. It's probably been ran over a few times. All right, get rid of that. Aww, this makes me so sad. You guys know I have a really hard time parting with things. Look how cute the basket is.
Remember, just spur of the moment going and getting this for her.
Yeah,
I
do.
Anything, we just went and got it.
Yep, I do. And I remember thinking at the time, which is so silly, everyone buys their kids new bikes, but I remember thinking, oh, I don't want people to think I'm spending too much money. Isn't that so weird? Moving on to the inside of our house, I told Joel, I said, these big dark frames that I've got, they don't really match the rest of like what I've got going on with the place. Like, they're just kind of heavy and dark and everything else is more chic, I guess. And that picture, our family picture, has always been right there. I ordered these, I'll have to show you when they're up, but these kind of acrylic clear picture frames. The ones I wanted had gold knobs, but they were like $100 a piece, or maybe $100 for two of them. And so I got on Amazon. The ones that had really good reviews had silver knobs. I thought the silver would be okay, just because there's a lot of silver in the house anyway too. I would prefer the gold ones, but the silver ones were like $26. So I went with those ones. And it was so cute because I was looking through the pictures that were inside the old picture frame, so I kept them all. Here's one. I don't have that first, very first one of like Olivia.
In the brown.
I don't have that. I know I have it somewhere. Maybe I should go see if I can find it. Anyway, so there's that one. This photographer was scary. This was the style. This was when like air editing, like we just look scary, okay? It's fine. I actually really love this picture, but the editing is a little wild. Here's this one. This was Shanda. She's the one that did our photography for the cookbook, and I just love her. On this day, you guys, on this day, we were walking up to this spot, and I was telling Shanda, I said, our photographer, I said, I think I'm gonna start a YouTube channel. And because she does a lot of makeup too. And she's like, oh, really? And I was kind of embarrassed to tell her because I was like, oh, she probably thinks I'm really stupid for wanting to start a YouTube channel. Isn't that funny? Here's the last one. Shanda also took this one. I loved these pictures. And guess what? Story time. There was a picture from like last year or the year before. I don't really know. I don't know how old these pictures are. A viewer messaged me and was like, hey, I live kind of in your area. I would love to take your guys' pictures. So we went up to this really beautiful area. We like met up with her. She got in our car. We drove like an hour up to this like location. The pictures were so beautiful. Like I was dying. We got individuals of the kids. We got a family one. And then she's like, hey, I will get these pictures back to you in like 2 days. And I was like, oh, amazing. We like totally hit it off. We were gonna go to dinner with her and her husband. And then a month later, I was like, hey, I've messaged you a few times. Can I get those pictures from you? I really need them. Like I have a deadline for what I needed those for. And she completely ghosted me. I was DMing her, I was calling her, I was texting her, I was emailing her, nothing. Finally, she messaged me back and was like,
my computer's in the shop, and when I get my computer back, I'll get them for you.
She never ended up telling me exactly why she never gave me those pictures, but I think she lost them. Like, I think she accidentally deleted them or something. Like, I don't really know, but it was in the fall. So by the time I like knew what was going on, it was too late for those kind of pictures. It was winter. Anyway, that was a nightmare. Long story short, we need new family pictures. It's disturbing because there wasn't digital prints when we got these, which it's just weird to think about, but I can't find the family picture that goes with this. I'm gonna be so sad if I can't find it. Found it! It's a little smaller than the other ones, but that is our first family picture, everybody. And there's this tag that's been going around on Instagram that's like, tag the first picture of you and your maybe husband, I don't know, me and Joel. And I couldn't remember what one. I think this is pretty close to it though. Or it's this one, I can't remember. Which one was first, the four-wheeling or the dam?
Four-wheeling, dam was, yeah, that later. Was still in high school.
But is this our first picture together, do you think?
No.
What's our first one together?
Well, that's our first of just me and you. We have yeah. one in junior high at a dance.
Oh, well, just of me and you.
Just me and you, that's yeah. the first.
Aw, that's funny. Wedding photo, anybody? yes. I'm so annoyed with myself because I just like quickly put these up. There is less space between this wall mount and the frame. And there's more from here to here. And then right here, you can tell that this picture like turns in. It's ridiculous. I shouldn't have rushed it, but I kind of don't care. I'm over it, I'm done. That's exciting. So as we're doing some cleaning and stuff, the fence right here apparently was falling over. So, you know, we're just getting that taken care of. Here's our main street. I'm not going into any stores or anything, but I wanted to come down and look at a sign that was down here. All of the stores are closed. I chuckle because it's just so different. It's just such a different vibe and a different feel. I keep calling these guys to make a special order for Easter, and I wanted to see, oh, they're actually open. I don't really want to go in. I just want to ask them if I can make an order. I think they deliver, so anyway, that's what I'm doing here. I just got done shredding my chicken and it turned out so flippin' good. I put just a little bit of olive oil and the zest and juice of 2 limes. It smells delicious. Anyway, we're having salads topped with pico. That's what we're doing for dinner tonight. And I was grabbing a Tupperware to put my chicken in and I was just disgusted with my Tupperware drawer. And it's so weird. Guys, this is literally what my cupboards, like, that looks really nice, okay. And then, okay, that like looks really nice. Why do we treat our Tupperware drawers like they're trash? Kids all just came in and saw my boxes that I put by the garbage can. I got 2 of these extra airplanes off Amazon, of course. Where else would I buy anything else? Whoa, whoa, whoa. Yeah, we have to show them. Where's the other one that you guys have been playing with?
Oh, it's in my computer.
Okay, let's show these guys. You just turned it on. Yes. You guys, this thing was like $9. Is that not so cool? Oh, get away from the tree! Oh, oh, so lucky. Okay, run get it, run get it. Tell me that is not the coolest toy you have ever
ever played with. It has this little charging cable that you charge it with, and it works so well. It sat out in the rain. I thought for sure it was going to be destroyed. It's the cheapest, coolest toy you could ever, ever play with, right?
Mm-hmm.
Should we put it in the description for these guys?
Yeah.
Okay, he's like, I don't care. We have all, this is like really official in this Ziploc or good garbage bag. I have one of each item of our Bali clothes, and I'm going to drop these off to my sister-in-law, Emily. And I thought it would be fun if we got in the car and just drove them over with the kids. We haven't even taken our kids really for a drive, I don't think. I'm trying to think of if we have, maybe I've just forgotten, but we're going to grab Lady and we're going to drive by, drop it on her doorstep, knock on the door, get back in the car, and if she wants to say hi, she can say hi to us from the car. But I thought that would be a nice pick-me-up for my sister-in-law, and I also thought that it might be nice so that she has an Easter dress to wear for Easter. And I'm turning right back around so that I can put the camera back in the house.